In this lesson, we're going to listen to Boss Rutan. He's a former MMA fighter and champion, and now he hosts several different shows and podcasts. And he was a guest on the Australian show Submission Radio. I chose this because you'll get some different accents and some good analysis. I want you to listen to it two times, more if you need it. Answer the true-false questions, and afterwards we'll look at the language they use and break it down. As I said before, the more advanced listeners listen to this video first. If you're less advanced or less confident, skip this video and go to the language highlight first. But let's get started.
McGregor-Mayweather fight that is now made official. It didn't look like it was going to happen for a while, but now it's going to be happening on August 26th. So we have to ask you, what was your reaction to the fight actually coming together and being made so soon?
I took it by surprise because I thought it was never going to happen. I thought it was just, just a thing, I guess, right? I thought it would never happen, but I guess that Mayweather realized, wait a minute, we can make a crap load of money here, you know? And for McGregor already won. You know, if he's going to pocket $60, $80 million, I mean, he cannot lose. Even if he loses against the best, pretty much, boxer on the planet. And he steps out of his comfort zone. It's not even mixed martial arts or kickboxing. He fights him at his rules. So there's no losing for McGregor. There's a lot of pressure on Mayweather. He wants to have that 50-0. Every person that he walks, that he sees on the street or his team, they will all tell him how easy this fight is going to be. And as a fighter, you do not want to hear that because now you better win. It's almost, and I explained this also in another interview, it's like fighting a girl. You know, you cannot lose because if you lose to a girl. But if, you know, if you win, well, you were supposed to win. You see what I mean? So there's a no-lose situation for McGregor. If he connects with his left hand, because he does have power in his left, he might knock him out. But that chance is very, very slim against the best defensive boxer on the planet.
What are you looking forward to more, Bas? The fight itself or the pre-fight festivities and the trash talk? Because you know it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, the trash talk, I'm looking forward to that. I want to see how McGregor is going to try to get inside the head of Mayweather. And Mayweather is a great trash talker as well. So I think we're going to see some fireworks. I think a lot of people, I threw a number out there that people thought I was crazy. I think 5.5 million pay-per-view buys are going to be, I believe 4,800 was against Pac-Man. So Pacquiao, so I truly believe that this can actually top it because of the way they're going to build it. Everybody's going to be tuned in. McGregor is going to be McGregor like he always is. Mayweather is going to be him. It's going to make for a spectacle. This is American TV. That's what this is.
I mean, you mentioned the pressure that's on Floyd and how really McGregor has not that much to lose in this fight. And he's already, you know, going to get a huge paycheck. So he's pretty much already won just by this fight coming together. But for everybody listening out there that's trying to figure out, okay, how would McGregor do this? I mean, there's a lot of theories floating around. One, McGregor goes out there, he starts coming forward towards Mayweather, tries to knock him out early. Another theory is McGregor tries to play mind games with Floyd at the start of the fight, save his energy and try and put him away a little bit later. A lot of people believe Mayweather is going to drag this out a little bit, use a lot of his defensive boxing and then eventually finish McGregor sort of later on in the fight. How do you see McGregor's path to victory here? In your mind, what is the most likely way he can do it?
Let Mayweather come to him. Mayweather's really good defensive and countering. Let Mayweather come to McGregor. That's what I would do. Once he comes in, it's just what happens with Aldo. You know, we never expected Aldo's striking skills are phenomenal and unbelievable. I never expected this, but what he did, he got angry because McGregor was making fun of him, and that's why he bull rushed in, and boom, he landed that big punch. Now, hopefully, he can do the same thing with Mayweather, but Mayweather, yeah, you know, the guy is just a really good boxer. So I don't know even know if he can get inside his head, because he's such an athlete, but if he does get inside his head, you know, you saw with Ronda Rousey what happened with Holm. And actually, if you think about it, it happened exactly the same to McGregor and Nate Diaz. Because once they had their first fight, I remember they were at, I believe it was a press conference at the weigh-in, that suddenly McGregor hit Diaz's hand. He lost his cool. And that meant that Diaz got inside his head. And then he lost the fight. And it was fun because when the first time it happened with Holm and Rousey, I had a person standing behind me. We were looking at the way that Rousey was losing her cool. And my buddy goes right away, she's going to lose, dude. We got to put money on Holm. She's going to lose. So then she lost. And then what happened with Mayweather, with McGregor and Diaz, the same guy behind me said, dude, he's going to lose. McGregor's going to lose. And he did lose. You see, so it's all about the mind games. If you can really get inside the head of your opponent, get him angry, let him come out firing, and because he's angry, he's loading up his punches instead of throwing it just from where they are, yeah, then that Mayweather could get knocked out. But again, we're talking about a Mayweather, you know, so, you know, he's not a really nice human being, but I have to admit that this guy is a phenomenal athlete.
He is. He...
If you want to check your answers and you like this type of exercise, sign up for the complete course below. You'll have interactive listening videos like this one, plus an e-workbook with all of the exercises inside.